capacitor. So, in doing this, we're looking at we're going to be looking at how the instantaneous value of current voltage change in a capacitor circuit charges when it's discharged. It must be designated by lower levels. Yeah. For example, if we're talking about voltage, is uppercase really to represent peak value? Maximum voltage value. Yeah. Lowercase v at time t, instantaneous voltage. At time t. Do you need in your writings and in your answers to exam questions, make it very clear the difference between a nominal maximum value or the applied value, capital letter, and an instantaneous value that is dependent upon time t, and it could be changing. It doesn't necessarily have to be that moment in time, but could be. It changes over time. And then we'd have IM, maximum current, flowing, which will flow at some point in the area of the circuit, okay. And then I, lowercase I, which is a bit easier to make sure you show it lowercase because it's with a dot on top at time t. That's instantaneous. Yep. And these are both in seconds. Because normally it does take. Alright, so that's. We'll have to be careful with that when we look at this situation. Okay. So, over the whole session, we're going to deal with charge and discharge. We're going to start with charge. I'm going to start with a circuit. With a capacitor, that value, state, connected to, through a switch. And over here, a graph. Of a time t of how little v t changes to that being a maximum value. I'll do that in x I little v t, start that in red. Little VC. I think that's my mind. When I look at the capacitor voltage and the resistor voltage, little VC in red, little VR in green. You're going to look at I in blue. Yep. We go further on in stuff. Talking about the point where t equals 0 seconds. The instant the switch is turned on. Yep. So, right at that instant, how much current will flow? What would VC be? If we're starting from scratch, so before we had 0 volts there. Yep. So the instant has turned on. What's the voltage across the resistor? These two can't be plotted. Kirchhoff's law is a law. It has to be obeyed at any instant in time. Remember me saying at any instant in time? So we're talking about circuit where things are changing, sometimes rapidly, sometimes not so rapidly, depending on the component values. But we're looking at an instant in time. At any instant you look at that circuit, it must balance Kirchhoff's law twice. Okay, if that's 8 volts, what else has changed? So we come down here to VR. The current is now not 1 amp, 0.8 amps. So the current is moving southwards, down that way. Alright, and again, so now if we carry on with that, catch up on that, so just summarising that so far, time on the x-axis, voltage on the y-axis, And if we follow the blue line, if we carry charging on at the rate of the blue line, i.e. a constant current supply, we'd hit VM in what's called one time constant, one time power. You can also calculate the time constant by multiplying capacitance by the resistance. Alright? And if we go to 2CR, 3CR, 4CR, alright, 5CR, which was considered to be fully charged. As you'll see shortly, we'll do some calculations and give you a formula calculating that will be C at time T. You'll see that that's 99.99% will be charged after 5 times. And this charge rate is so repeatable that little CR circuits can be used in time where they want a ramp. You can create a ramp voltage by supplying a capacitor with a constant current source. If you use 1 amp or half an amp, you'll get a ramp, a voltage that rises up to a limit. Straight on instead of a and you can charge your capacitor and take readings, and that will be very repeatable. Yep. Okay. To summarise, calculation-wise, big one's little VC. Current on. We can calculate little VC by VM, which is there, times 1 minus to the minus T over CR. It's in that form. Okay. We can calculate little VR M T. We are. Calculate M. This is current, which must be equal to half the switch off. Yep. got a... the time constant. B. B. C. After. 1 times the R. Volts, i.e. 99% of the applied voltage after 5 times. Yep. So, if you add another time constant over there, that'll get 63% closer. But, for all intents and purposes, but that's a trickle that has to charge up to level the current. If we do I, the last bit of C, on I after 1 time constant, till I is equal to, then what's the initial current that's going to that current is going to be a switch on, 1 amp, so there's probably 10 volts across there, it's going to be 1 amp. Did you get that, Daniel? Yeah, 1 amp, yeah. So that's going to be 1 times E to the minus 1 over 1. E to the minus 1. If E drop by 63%. Just drop by 63% to start. And again, another time constant. I drop 63% to put back to zero. Another time constant. Still, you get the 5 time constant. Alright? Alright, Daniel? Get all that? Okay, we're just going to look at a situation where you might need to rearrange one of those formulas. So, we're going to say, what a previous problem. Five. When see 5 volts. Right, we'll go through this together step by step. So we got a formula. Pm plus 1 minus E to minus T. And at the moment I'm going to, instead of writing CR, I'm going to write tau. We can always get the C or the R value at the time of tau. We're going to find the time of tau. Right. I want to rearrange that to get T on its own. Where do we start? Daniel, what you're going to do, what you're going to do, why just, what? If you expand the brackets, you're creating more of an issue because you've got 3m minus 3m times e to the minus t of a tau. You've got 2vm to move. You aren't simplifying the problem. Yeah. So if we get rid of this by dividing by the when I put divided by, I mean divide both sides by. Yeah. So we'll get the little c of a Vm on this side is equal to, and as you rightly say, Daniel, once you've got rid of that multiplication, you can take the brackets of 1 minus e. The minus t of the tau. Yeah. Next. Yeah. That ties up, that makes that positive. Remember, this is, remember what we're looking for, we're looking for trying to isolate that. Square root of the side, you've got square root of all of that, and then I've got this. We don't want this, do we? Well, VC of a VM is a number. You just take that away, put in ratio, take it away all in one go. So, track VC of a VM. So we leave e to the minus t on the tau on this side equal to 1 minus VC of a VM on the right. Now, what's next? We've got to extract that t from the exponential function. So we're looking for the opposite function of e to the power of x. The key to that, right in front of you on your calculator, on your chart. Because they put opposite functions. The same key. E to the x is the shift function of Ln. So Ln must be the opposite of e to the x. So we've got to take the natural log of both sides. If we do Ln both sides, what we're saying we're going to do is we're going to Ln that as long as we do Ln of that. And the process of taking the log cancels that out and just leaves minus t of the tau that side. So writing out in full what we've got left is this side minus t tau equal to natural log 1 minus little bt of a gamma. Close the brackets. We're getting there now. Multiply by tau, giving us minus t is equal to ln, sorry, tau times ln bracket 1 minus c of the m. How can I make time t positive? Effectively, what I need to do is multiply by minus 1, first side. Minus 1 times minus t is t, and then minus 1 times all of that is minus tau ln 1 minus dt. Now we've got a formula for time in terms of time constant, which we know as CR for meter. We've got our data 1 second, so we can put our numbers in here now. So at t, at when VC equals 5 volts, t is equal to minus tau, which is 1, minus 1 times ln of 1 minus little vc 5 volts over vm 10 volts close brackets. Should be, what should it be less than, just before we push any buttons? Less than 10. Time, what should the time be less than? Think back to an earlier couple. Time constant. After one time constant, what was the capacitor voltage? 6.3 volts. So therefore, we're below time when we hit the first time constant, but less than a second. Do you get that or not? Yeah? We know after 1 second we hit 6.3 volts. We must hit 5 volts before that. The answer must be less than that. We're going to look at now in our later foundation. Imagine that we've passed the charge current such that we've charged this capacitor test box. What will VR be? At that moment, just switch off. Yeah? And what's the direction of it? Of that arrow? What's the positive for that? Turn it off slowly. Anti-clockwise arrow signal. No other arrows. Clockwise arrow must be. Yep. The capacitor is the supply to that resistor. So we've taken away the 10 volt source. Short it out. We've switched it on. So we've charged up with the current in that direction. It's a charged current in the opposite. Initially, so VR times the zero is also current, and for completeness, I'm going to make it clear that the current's going in the opposite direction to the point we charged it. So I'm going to put it down. Here, and it's 1 amp maximum. Just making it clear, it's basically opposite maximum to what it was. Then the various kit, this will gradually discharge